let's get to it. So the audition, they asked you to audition for SNL. Did you feel prepared for that audition?
We didn't come from the improv world. A lot of people that get that audition have been cultivating their fucking characters forever, workshopping them, knowing what works, knowing like what they're best at. None of that. Andy had done stand-up. We had I did more dramatic stuff or something. But when you get the audition, it's like, and you're doing it in 7 days. So you're flying out. You're it's terrifying. It's fucking terrifying. And even getting the audition is a massive. That's like success just to get the audition.
Absolutely,
it's super hard. So Andy did it, and then I had again 5 days to prepare. I did what I could do, but I was like, I was the year that I was also. This is just me silver lining it, being like, this is why I didn't get the show. But I'm like, I was going up against Hater got on.
Sudeikis.
Andy, Sudeikis, fucking, I was like, these are fucking hitters.
And honestly,
really when I look at it, I'm like, I don't know how good I would have been on the show.
But wait, I heard on, that you got a laugh from Tina Fey.
I got a laugh from Tina Fey, and that was like my crowning achievement.
What was the joke?
I did one character, I did a Macedonian dude.
Something I got to bring up to you guys, okay? Recently, some of you guys have been trying to assassinate me. Okay, not cool, you guys. Come on, we're all Macedonians here, yeah!
And then I did a character that was a 13-year-old at a bar mitzvah, and it was just really, it was like basically just two guys level awkwardness of like, his song comes on at the bar mitzvah, he clearly wants to dance, and it's just like a... and just like, was really nervous, and I got an audible laugh from Tina Fey, and I was like, fuck, at least I have that.
When Key was on, he said that you guys made a pact. He said that if Andy got on and one of you guys didn't get on, you both would turn down the job.
Will be forever. The story that you told about Akiva being that a certain type of way with the specificity of that is one side of Kiev. The other side of Kiev is that level of loyalty where I was I was like, holy shit, I wouldn't have even thought to say that. And the fact that I know that motherfucker means it.
Yeah.
And he's for real.
Yeah.
Is like, that's fucking badass. Let me tell you how the story go. When I was younger.